I'm Devishree of grade 9 from MM Vidyashram. I'm sure that you have played with the fidget spinner, right? Have you ever thought that this spinning toy is similar to the structure of an atom? Well, that's what we are going to explore today. And also learn about the location and arrangement of subatomic particles and Thomson's, Rutherford's and Bohr's model of an atom. A scientist by the name J.J. Thomson, who discovered the electron, proposed a plum pudding model. By that time, neutrons have not been found, so the scientists were only working with protons and electrons. And what about the plum pudding model? He said that the electrons are like the tiny plums which are embedded in the large positive pudding. Here, I don't have a plum pudding. Instead, I'm going to use this watermelon. This large red mass is positively charged, and the seeds are like the electrons which are embedded in it. And this model also tells about the electrically neutral nature of an atom. But he could not explain the results of various experiments carried out by many other scientists. A scientist by the name Ernest Rutherford came with an interesting experiment. He totally disproved the J.J. Thomson's atomic model. To analyze the structure of an atom, Rutherford and his students bombarded the thin layer of atoms with the help of tiny particles and studied the deflection of these tiny particles. Now, how did you get the thin layer of atoms? I'm sure you have seen the aluminum foil, right? The one you use in the kitchen to wrap food. But he used a gold foil. Since gold is the most malleable metal, so it can be beaten even more thinner than the aluminum foil. Here, I don't have a gold foil. Instead, I'm going to use this golden paper. And how did he get the tiny particles? That or the alpha particles, which are positively charged. Each alpha particle is basically a helium nucleus since it has two protons and two neutrons in it. And what about the charge of an alpha particle? It's plus 2 since it has two protons in it. The alpha particles are like the tiny bullets which are emitted from the radioactive sources like radium. Now, what did he do? He took the gold foil like this and he bombarded it with a alpha particles. Now, let's try to recreate it. For that, I need your help. Let's imagine we are going to magnify this thin layer of atoms. There. How it looks? It looks like this. As I've already told you, the thickness of a gold foil is about 1000 atoms, but for simplicity, I've taken a single layer of atom. Now, I'm going to bombard this. These are the alpha particles which I'm going to represent. And I'm going to bombard it with the help of these alpha particles. As you can see, most of them got deflected, only some passed straight through. But the actual result was completely opposite. This is what Rutherford and his students expected, but the actual observation was completely opposite. They observed that most of the particles passed straight through and only some got deflected at smaller and larger angles and very, very few got rebounded back to the original path. It's like the atom is kind of empty. Yeah, that is what he expected. And what did he conclude? He concludes that an atom is basically hollow since most of the particles pass straight through. And only some got deflected at smaller and larger angles, and I've already told you very, very few got rebounded back to their original path. This states that all positive mass is in a very little, occupies a very little space. And all positive charges and masses are concentrated in a small volume within the atom. Now, I'm going to go ahead and remove this model and I'm going to replace it with this new model. This is also called the nuclear model of atom. So this green, tiny green balls represent the nucleus of an atom. So that's why it's called it's a nuclear model. And this is all positive charge and masses. Now let me do it again with this new model. Most of them pass straight through. some got deflected at smaller and larger angles, and very, very few got rebounded back to their original path. This states that there is a positively charged center, that is the nucleus. Nearly all mass is within the nucleus. The size of the nucleus is small as compared to the size of the atom. And the electrons revolve around the nucleus of an atom. This is what Rutherford states, but he too have some drawbacks. He didn't explain about the stability of an atom. Here comes the Bohr's atomic model. As you can see, this is similar to the solar system model. See, this nucleus is similar to the sun, and these electrons are similar to the planets, which are revolving around in a fixed circular path. So these paths are called orbits. We can also call this as shells or energy levels. By the word energy level, it will be talking about the important concept that while electrons are moving in these shells, they won't liberate any energy. They won't radiate any form of energy. This is what Niels Bohr suggested. And later in 1932, James Chadwick discovered the neutron and stated that it does not have any charge, and the mass of the neutron is similar to, it's almost equivalent to the mass of the proton. And yeah, now I'm complete with my structure of an atom. Now, whenever you're playing with this fidget spinner, you would know that the spinning part is the electron, and this heavier particle, that is the nucleus, is on the center. Yeah, I'm done with my project. Thank you.
Good morning to all. I'm going to explain to you this model, food pyramid. This is the model shows balanced diet and healthy food. Children need carbohydrate, vitamin, mineral, fiber, and fats. This is the first layer. In this layer, we can see millet, ragi, wheat, oats, maize, rice. These kind of foods has lot of carbohydrate. These are natural food items, so we must eat these foods. This is the second layer. In this layer, we can see milk, vegetable, fruits. These kind of foods has lot of minerals and vitamin. The second layer is equal to the first layer. The same quantity of fruits and vegetables is the same quantity of rice. This is the third layer. In this layer, we can see fish, chicken, meat. These kind of foods has lot of proteins, but we must eat these foods weekly once. This is the fourth layer. In this layer, we can see chips, cool drinks, and chocolates. These kind of foods has lot. These are called junk foods. These has lot of fats. So we must avoid these foods. If you see the pyramid, you will be understand the healthy food and unhealthy foods. The first layer or the basic layer is the healthy food. The fourth layer is the unhealthy food. We must avoid these foods. Thank you.
Good morning all. I am Cynthia, studying 6th standard. Now, I am going to show you two experiments. My first experiment going to be Eno gas balloon. For this, the required things are a bottle, cup of water, half lemon, packet of Eno, and a balloon. First, take the bottle. Pour the lemon and water.
What is the required things are? A plate, cup of colored water, a glass, and a matchbox. First, take the plate, place the candle. Place the candle center of the plate. Then take the water, pour inside the plate. Then take a glass in the inverted position on the candle. You can see as the flame goes off, the water outside the glass is slowly rising inside the glass. It is happening because it's making the pressure outside the glass equated the pressure inside the glass, and we got force on it. Thank you all.